Do you know what's in your pre-roll? If not, stick around to find out. We're working with. What do y'all think we should choose? We did a video. Save those for later. What? I'm gonna go ahead and do that. I'm gonna do a pre-roll video for y'all today. On the way, I got a backpack loaded up. Gonna get in the car for me. We're not in the car. Gonna go to my boy's house, smoke these joints for you.
I'm gonna save these for the video, but I'm gonna go ahead and cut this one open. You know, I'm not gonna say the brand name or anything like that, but this is what we're talking like, you know, just to show y'all what's really in your pre-rolls. You know, make sure y'all should be checking what's really in your fucking pre-roll. Like, if you don't, you know, just go ahead, like, dump it out. I'm breaking it in half, you don't have to do this. But, look, if you wanna smoke what's coming out of your pre-roll in a bowl, then definitely don't smoke the pre-roll bag. Like, if you, cause like, look at this shit. What is this? What is this? This is, like, look at this. That is not good. You do not want to smoke that. Like, that's so dry. Not even sticky, dry. Not good. But we're gonna go ahead and get into the good pre-rolls. I was just showing y'all guys what's inside your pre-rolls. You know, if y'all haven't ever opened one, you know, you don't have to break the whole thing in half. You can just, like, cut the tip off or whatever. Pause. But you just, like, cut the tip off and, you know, dump a little bit out. And if you wouldn't smoke it out of a bowl, then just go ahead and throw the fucking pre-roll away. You don't even need to be smoking it. But, no, I'm going to go ahead and start with this one. This one smells like candy. Straight up candy. I don't know. Like, maybe like a strawberry banana smoothie almost. But it tastes like candy. You got a lighter? Fuck.
Yeah.
Out there.
Fuck what I wouldn't have a lighter.
Okay. Got the Zippo for this. Dude, this shit is wet. I couldn't even pull through it.
Me too.
Nice and sticky. Pause. Yeah, let's go and get that slow motion for you.
God damn.
Well, this shit's hitting. Woo. You know, if I'd have to give that a taste, you know, for the taste of it, that's probably like, I don't know.
Tastes like shit.
Tastes like shit?
Yep.
Apparently it tastes like shit to him. I don't know, I don't think it tastes that bad. It definitely doesn't taste how it smells though. It doesn't taste like candy. But what the fuck? It's like breaking at the end.
It's limp.
What do you mean?
It's going limp, bro. It's going soft.
That's actually good. Hold on, the fiber just came through. Look at that ash. Pretty nice and white. It's pretty much what you want to see on the joints. Oh, the fucking wax is melting in it. It's just straight wax.
Bitch said 10 minutes, you already halfway through. Why are you holding it like that?
Fucking. Well, all right. So this is when they fuck up and put too much wax in it.
It looks like my shit when I'm soft.
This is what. Pause. But no, this is what this shit looks like when you put too much fucking wax in it. It doesn't smoke. But hey, this was a free pre-roll I got. And I mean, for the smell alone, it's probably just some disty in here. No, that's probably what. Fuck it. It ain't good, man. You know, this is really the good one right here. This is the $10 one that I paid for. So, you know, if y'all out here buying $10 pre-rolls, this is really what you're expecting to get, basically. But this one isn't as big as the last one, not as long. So, but, you know, still coated in Keef. This is supposed to be an infused pre-roll, and it does say 10-minute burn time. It has 0.25 wax and 0.25 Keef. So, you know, you're getting half a gram of keeping wax mixed together, so you know, hopefully this one's gonna smoke a lot better. And this is Grape Ape, if y'all didn't know the strain, but I was gonna get into it. Oh, that's gas. Try that one. Yeah, that one almost tastes like grapes. Like, just think of like weed and grapes mixed together, and that's basically what that one tastes like. And the rating on that one, I'm probably gonna have to give it like a 6 or a 7. You know, it's definitely not the best tasting shit I've ever had. If you're really looking for taste, I recommend go ahead and try out Dabs. Dabs definitely just give the best flavor in my opinion, but that's not too bad for a $10 pre-roll. I mean, I would pay $10 for that again, I'll be honest. It's smoking pretty good.
Tastes good.
Yeah, shit does taste good. That last one, I don't know. Never smoke the free pre-rolls, I promise you. Never smoke the free pre-rolls.
Smoking a lot.
Oh God, it is. But yeah, definitely let me know in the comments what y'all smoking along with us. You know, let me know what carts y'all got. Smoking all that bong, whatever y'all got. You know, definitely let me know in the comments. Also, since you're still here, might as well go ahead and like and subscribe. You know, it really does help me out when y'all hit that like button. And if y'all subscribe, because my shit gets age restricted basically on upload sometimes. So, you know, if it gets a few likes in the first like 20 minutes, then it doesn't get age restricted. But, you know, if it doesn't, then it doesn't. But. Yo, look at that ash on that. Nice and white. Real sticky. Smoking all the way good through, you know, not all limp like the last one. But depending on the brand, I feel like you really get what you pay in pre-rolls. If you're buying $5 pre-rolls, they're going to put shit weed. All right? You're not going to get exotic weed. If you're buying $150 pre-rolls, you're getting gas in it. All right? You're probably going to get some hash. Probably going to get some gas weed. You know, some keef, diamonds. You're going to get all the good stuff. But if you're buying $10, $15 pre-rolls, you know, some, it depends on the brand. Some of them good, some of them bad. Probably Black Market's going to be your best. In the cheaper pre-roll category. But yeah, also let me know what y'all did today. You know, it's Saturday, so let me know if y'all had a good day today and whatnot. Hopefully y'all didn't have to go to work. Also, if y'all didn't know, they're just ash in these containers. They're like perfect for keeping the ash. Then you just close it up. It's not gonna smell. Also, if you didn't watch my last video about Delta 8 carts being banned, you know, make sure to watch that video. What the fuck?
Yeah, it's the neighbors.
Bro, somebody fucking.
You want a Porsche?
You want a Porsche?
Yeah, $6,000
Porsche. Yeah, 944? Oh, them are clean. Just an engine rebuild. Yeah. Sounds slight.
Yeah, rebuild it. Just rebuild it.
Sounds slight. You just gotta fix the whole car, bro. You know, like.
That's only if you got, like, a new one.
Yeah, it was only underwater, like.
Nah. Only thing problem with it is it's got an accident.
Yeah, okay. Yeah, I got totaled one time. You know, that's the only problem with it.
I got totaled. This dude just fixed it.
And this guy fixed it. Now you gotta fix it because it got crashed again.
Nah, he put all the junk in it.
Yeah, hey, if y'all are in the cars,
flywheel.
But now if y'all are in the cars, I do have a Saab 9.3. If y'all were wondering, that shit's pretty gas.
It's broken.
It's broken though. It's broke. We need to get monetized. If we do get monetized, then maybe I can fix the car, post some car videos, not car videos, but like smoking with the car and shit.
You need to fix the car regardless.
Oh God, I need to fix the car regardless, but.
Got old fucking supers on here too.
Look at that, smoking even all the way to the end. You know, this isn't a shitty pre-roll. For $10 what I paid for it, I'm not mad. I'd definitely buy it again. Same taste all the way through as well.
Yeah, they sell them supers too. $2,000 Supra. But I'm not trying to buy a drop 10 bands on a new transmission for a Supra.
Hey bro, if y'all want a $2,000 Supra, go look at Facebook Marketplace. Heard they out there. But you're gonna spend about 100 grand on that engine.
Just steal one.
About 15 grand on transmission. And it's still not gonna run good.
It'll run good. It's a Toyota.
I mean, it's gonna run good, but like.
You gotta put mods on it to make it really fast.
But look, as soon as
you gotta drop more money.
And then as soon as you put mods on it, it's not gonna run good. So.
You gotta put a tune on it, drive it's like. Three bands.
Yeah, if you want a good tune.
Good tune, three bands. So we're already like $100,000 deep.
And the car's not even gonna start when it's cold. Cause you're on E85, making 1,000 horsepower. Your car's not gonna start. You're only gonna be able to drive it sometimes. Can't drive it in the rain. It spins out.
Can't drive it in the rain. It spins out.
Can't drive it at night because you probably don't have. You only have one headlight.
Track only trash car. At driving. You still need trash at driving.
Track only car, basically. It's not fun at that point. Yeah, I know a lot of y'all that smoke weed definitely are in the car. So, you know, what y'all take on it? Would y'all rather have a fast car that you can only really take to the track and only drive in the, like, sunny conditions? Or would you rather have, like, a car that's not as fast, like maybe like a 600, 400 wheel horsepower car that's still gapping most things on the street, right? But you're able to drive it whenever because it's not as uncontrollable.
We're talking about where it's at, bro. Let's say.
Yeah, I'm not talking about that.
We're not. I'm not trying to get DDoSed, bro.
Okay. Once you hand it back, I'm gonna end the video. So.
Fuck. Yeah, it's 3 fucking hours from here. And it's insane because it's like that deep.
Damn.
It's also like it's got divots.
Never heard of it.
So like you'll hit a turn and think you'll be good and it'll be like the road will be uneven and you'll hit that bitch and then lose control and there's no rail. It's just woods. So it'll slide off, fly into a tree.
No, that's it for the video. No. If you like the video, make sure to like, comment, subscribe, all that good shit, and peace, boys, stay safe.